When it comes to cooking, most of us tend to stick with our tried and true methods. You know, it works, so why change it?
Well, today we are showing you a method for cooking bacon that you probably haven't tried before. And as our resident scientist food blogger, Clark Cassarella, explains, when you boil bacon, you get perfect results every time.
Welcome, Clark.
Yeah.
Today you're going to show us what you, it's kind of a self-proclaimed, mind-blowing way of cooking bacon.
It's a little revolutionary, and it is unorthodox because you might not ever think to do it, but you cook bacon in water. And there's a few reasons why you'd want to do that.
Okay, what are they?
The first reason, bacon is a very highly volatile food to cook, so whenever you hit the Maillard reaction, which happens at 300 degrees Fahrenheit, you can easily burn bacon, so it becomes super crunchy. You never render out any of the fat, so you kind of get this layer of really hard crunch, and then it's all soggy and fatty in the middle of it.
So let's go rewind a sec.
Yeah.
Maillard reaction, that's
yes.
A word you said that I don't know that everybody knows.
True. So the Maillard reaction is a complex series of chemical reactions that happens whenever you cook food. And that is basically the thing that causes browning to occur.
Is it also sort of what produces some of the aroma?
It does to a degree,
okay.
And it also leaves, you know, anything left in the pan.
And that happens at 300 degrees.
It does happen at 300 degrees.
So what we're doing today, how is the way we're cooking it sort of sidestepping that then?
The reason why you want to cook it in water is because water, when it boils, only gets to 212 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay. So we're going to be able to cook it all the way through without risking getting to 300.
Correct. And since bacon fat renders much lower temperature than that, you're actually allowing that bacon fat to melt out as it cooks in the water, and then it will crisp later on once all of that bacon fat has rendered out. So you end up with none of the sogginess. It's all crisp, just how bacon should be.
So science works.
Yeah, science does work.
Okay, let's take me through the process then. So you've got thick cut bacon.
Yeah, thick cut bacon. This generally doesn't work with super thin cuts.
Okay.
So, you know, try to go to your butcher, get the thickest stuff that you can get. And it's just as simple as laying down, you know, 3 or 4 strips of bacon into a pan and then covering it with enough water to kind of come up just a little bit over. And then put it on the stove, medium-low heat, 30 to 40 minutes.
30 to 40 minutes?
It does take a little bit longer, but this is great. You know, you start it Sunday morning, get some pancakes going.
Maybe make some bread.
Make some more bread.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's really no frills involved. You don't need a splatter screen at all because it's such a gentle way to cook the bacon. No splattering is involved.
It's a gentle way to cook the bacon.
Yeah.
So we're just going to fill it up with water enough to cover the bacon.
Yes.
Will it actually come all the way up to a boil while we're cooking it?
It will, yeah.
Okay.
And all of that water goes away. It will boil off. So then all that's left in the pan is bacon fat. So then it fries in its own fat.
All right. Let's fill it up with water and see this magic, mind-blowing way to cook bacon.
Yeah.
So you're a science person, what should we call you?
A science nerd.
A science nerd. Your education and your background is definitely in science.
Yes.
How did you take that and then decide to translate it to cooking?
A lot of sort of television shows when I was growing up. You have shows like Good Eats, a lot of new cookbooks like The Food Lab from J. Kenji Lopez-Alt. It's a way to bring science and sort of precision into your home kitchen. It allows you to make things a lot more uniformly. It allows you to put those sort of novel concepts to work. You know, really, cooking is just thermodynamics.
That's what I say all the time. Cooking is just thermodynamics.
It really is. So,
yes.
So if you're able to sort of understand how heat affects things, what happens whenever you do boil water, what happens whenever a piece of cold meat touches a hot pan, what's going on there? It kind of helps you understand what's happening to your food and maybe not just why you're doing things to food.
But you don't have to have a PhD.
Absolutely
in...
Absolutely
not. What's your blah, blah?
Nuclear physics.
Nuclear physics. You don't have to have
no.
a PhD in nuclear physics to understand some of the science behind cooking.
No.
But it certainly is kind of a way where you sort of got interested in it.
Yes,
okay.
and it makes it a lot more approachable too. Break it down into simple concepts.
I like it a lot. Yeah. I like learning kind of how you can manipulate what you're cooking by understanding the science behind it.
It's super fun.
Okay, Clark, is it done, do you think?
It's good
to go. So I'm just going to pick it up so we can kind of talk about it here. Tell me how we knew it was done.
A lot of what you'll see, the water will completely evaporate. And then all of that bacon grease and fat that is rendered out of the bacon will start to foam. It makes tiny little, almost white bubbles, and that's how you know when you're almost done rendering all the fat out of it and you've started to brown the bottom of the pan. And you'll start to see little chunks of stuff sort of stick to the bottom of the pan as well. And that's your key.
You mentioned when we were just kind of getting to the end of it cooking that you could start to hear the sizzle change to be a little bit more of that sizzle on a pan and not boiling in water.
Correct.
Sound. Yeah.
When you first start it off, it's almost a hum, and then by the time when it's done, it's a crackle.
Yeah. So here, will you grab the tongue and pick it up for us? This smells really good, and I think you're right, kind of a mind-blowing way to make bacon. Look at that. Thank you so much for being here today showing us how to make bacon and also teaching us a little bit of the science.
A little bit of science goes a long way.
Thank you.
Thanks.